Southwest Lawrence Elementary. It is Friday. Woo-hoo. All right, it's Friday, January 27th, 2023. Let's observe a moment of silence and reflect on the anticipated activities of the day. Thank you. At this time, let's pledge allegiance to our country's flag. Everybody stand, salute, and pledge. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Please say the PBIS mission statement with me. At Southwest Lawrence Elementary, we aim to develop positive, hardworking, respectful achievers. For lunch today, we have hot dog, pizza, PBJ buddy bag, french fries, fresh veggies, and ranch. Happy birthday today to Jace Hester, and happy birthday tomorrow, Saturday, to Ariel Shiggs. Make sure you come by the office and grab a birthday pencil. And we'll sing to you if you want us to. Our core value this month is knowledge. Good job. Knowledge is learning something new so you can be better at whatever you do. We have to give ourselves permission to make mistakes in our quest for knowledge. Things never go perfectly. We will make mistakes and go off on the wrong track. Just remember that making mistakes is part of the learning process. All right, it's Raider Pass teacher lunch today. So if you got an email from Miss Tina, you get a duty-free lunch tomorrow, and we get to do lunch duty. Whoop, whoop. All right, Raider Pass winners, kindergarten from Miss Matthews' class, Micah Pittman and Remy Griffin. First grade, Kirsten Burns from Miss Gay and Iviana Glover from Miss Neesmith. Second grade, Liam Bayo from Miss Walker and Hudson Hatcher from Miss Reeves' class. Third grade, Mia Pacheco from Miss Litke and Sam Barossa from Miss Hester. Fourth grade, Dawson Murchison from Miss Register and Mackenzie Garnto from Miss Thomas. Fifth grade, Ryder Sermons from Miss Hall and Jasper Basemore from Miss Davis. Staff winners are Miss Patricia Razor, Miss Amy Faircloth, Miss Vicki Knight. Congratulations to all of these winners. Now these classes get to tote around the trophy for the week. From kindergarten, Miss Knight's class. First grade, Miss Neesmith's class. Second grade, Miss Gibson's class. Third grade, Miss Forney's class. Fourth grade, Miss Thomas's class. And fifth grade, Miss Tanner's class. Way to go, students. All right, we want you to have a wonderful week. And a wonderful weekend, actually, because it's Friday and you get 2 days off. So have a wonderful weekend and make sure you are the light this weekend, boys and girls. Now, I want you to stay tuned because we have a very special interview that happened this week from Mr. Rhett Clanton, one of our third grade students, and Ms. Litke, Ms. Williams, Wilkins class. And I want you to listen as he interviews this author. It's amazing. Have a great weekend, guys.
Okay, we're going to talk a little bit about a special situation that happened today. And Rhett, this is Rhett Clanton. I'm sitting here with third grader Rhett Clanton in Miss Litke's homeroom. And he was nominated for an opportunity to interview the author, Joanna Ho, who also wrote this book, wrote several books, and Rhett was one of four people chosen out of the whole United States to get to interview this famous author. So how did that make you feel, Rhett?
It made me feel great. I was nervous at first, but after it started, all my nerves got out of me, and then I just loved it, and it was great.
It was cool, wasn't it? And I got to sit in and listen some of it, and she seemed like a pretty cool person, didn't she?
Yes, ma'am.
Now, it seems like she told us a little bit about her reading abilities when she was in the elementary school. What did she say about reading?
She was very, very good at it. She loved reading. During the summer, she would try to check out every single book, and she just loved reading.
And that is what we're trying to promote here, because our kids, starting in kindergarten and some in pre-K, are already reading, and we are really trying to push that, and it helps. It will really help you become a better reader, a better writer as well, because she also told us something about her writing abilities. Was she a good writer when she was in elementary school?
She wasn't. She had to write an essay before. In 8 hours, she only wrote one sentence.
One sentence. So if you're not that good of a writer, don't give up. You keep working and let your teachers keep helping you with your writing abilities. And you'll see some of the writers on in the display case that we have outside in the front. And Rhett's cursive writing is displayed. It is incredible. So make sure you go by and look at that. And we have a lot of great writers in our school. We really do. But it was neat to hear the famous author. Now, how long ago did she start writing, Rhett?
8 years ago.
8 years ago. So, and when in elementary, she wasn't that good of a writer, but she became a good writer. And because she loved to read, it encouraged her to write. And she just started writing 8 years ago and already has several books published, including this one. What's the name of this one, Rhett?
Eyes That Speak to the Stars.
Do you remember what it's about?
It's about this boy, and he was getting picked on. So his friend, this was a picture, all of his friends, it was like a rainbow in the background, and he was the only one that had two eyes or two lines, and he felt really sad. And when he was, his dad always said that he always went in for a hug once he saw him on the pickup. And this time he got really sad. He didn't go on to a hug like he used to. He was so sad that he went to his dad and hugged him and he cried.
Okay, and Miss Joanna Ho, the author here, she actually mentioned that. That's what encouraged her. And it was based on actually something that had happened to her. Is that right, Rhett? And they had picked on her. And so it's very important to understand you should never pick on people. Everybody's different, and that's okay. That's what makes us a great school. That's what makes us a great world, that we all are different, and we have our own strengths, we have our own weaknesses. And I'm just so proud that we could do this interview today, because Rhett did a tremendous job on this, and it will be posted soon. We'll find it. They're going to finalize the edited version of the interview today, and hopefully it'll be posted on YouTube soon, and we'll be able to get that channel to you. So Rhett, thank you for representing our school well with this interview, and thank you for coming on and being on our morning news show.
You're welcome.
All right. Great job, buddy. I'm so proud of you. Have a good day. Keep reading and keep writing.
Bye.
Question is coming from. Hello. Can you tell us what your name is and what grade you're in?
Yes, ma'am. My name is Rhett, and I am in third grade.
Hi, Rhett.
Hey, Rhett. Okay,
you're handsome.
Ma'am.
Where are you calling in from?
Dublin, Georgia.
Oh, okay.
Georgia. I used to live in Georgia. Awesome. Okay, Rhett, what is your question for today?
What was school like, especially reading and writing, when you were in third grade?
Oh, gosh, third grade. Third grade was a long time ago for me. But I loved reading. So actually, third grade is when my parents got divorced. So that's actually what I remember most about third grade. But I loved reading. I've always really loved school. I've always been like the kid who would go to the library over the summer and try to read all the books and win all the summer reading contests, because that's just, I'm sort of bookwormy. I still am very bookwormy like that. I really struggled with writing. Actually, in elementary school, maybe it didn't feel like such a struggle, but when I was in high school, I had a really hard time. So I like to tell the story when I was a senior, so way older than third grade, but third grade is when I was building these skills. I had to write an essay and I sat in front of my computer for like 8 hours and I only wrote one sentence. And I didn't leave. I wasn't like procrastinating. I was like thinking and trying to figure out how to say the thing that I wanted to say. It was really, really hard for me. And so I think if there's anyone who's watching, if you struggle with reading or if writing feels really hard, just know that like the more you practice and the more you try, the more it comes. I mean, now I write and that's what I do for a living. And I never would have thought that that's something I would have done, you know, when I was growing up.
Were you a great reader and creative writer in school?
I was a great reader. I don't know that I was not a creative writer. I wasn't someone who like wrote stories and thought I wanted to be an author. I definitely loved reading and diving in and falling into these new worlds. But I didn't start writing. I didn't write creatively at all until like 8 years ago.
Hmm. That is awesome. Red.
Your eyes just, they look a lot like mine, it looks like.
Yeah.
I mean, everybody that's been picking on your eyes, I think they shouldn't have done that.
Oh, thank you so much. I wish they hadn't either, but that means so much. And that's one reason I wrote some of my books is so, you know, not just people who look like me, but all people can read books and just appreciate each other for who we are. Thanks,
Red. That's beautiful.
Thank you so much, Rhett, for your question and for just the way that you are pouring into even adults. So you just keep that up, okay? You keep doing that in your community.
Yes, ma'am.
All right. Have a good one, Rhett.
Bye.
Bye.
Bye, Rhett. I know.
Bye.
Well, it is time to announce our Students of the Month for the month of January. These students are recognized for showing knowledge this month. We'll start with our pre-K. From Ms. Slaughter's class, Baylor Poulton. From Ms. Manley's class, Caden Johns. From Ms. Monroe's class, Marshall Adcock. From Ms. Walker's class, Colton Hall. From kindergarten, Ms. Beasley's class, Wilder Terry. Ms. Matthews' class, Donna Harris. Ms. Floyd's class, Titus Montgomery. Ms. Young's class, Kamari Chambers. From Ms. New's class, Claire Knight. From Ms. Wood's class, Adelina Alvarez. From Ms. Lord's class, Braylee Wynn. From Ms. Hardy's class, Ayana O'Neill. For first grade, from Ms. Harris's class, Everly Bellflower. From Ms. Birch's class, Addie Yancey. From Ms. Outlaw's class, Lane Wood. From Ms. Thompson's class, Patience Hudson. From Ms. Hester's class, Owen Wood. From Ms. Neesmith's class, Parker Coffin. From Ms. Gay's class, Lennox Manley. For second grade, from Ms. Smith's room, Kaylee Diaz. From Ms. Fuller's class, Olivia Gibson. From Ms. Reeves' class, Maddox Brooks. From Ms. Holt's class, Jocelyn Flanders. From Ms. Walker's class, Jasmine Thigpen. From Ms. Gibson's class, Nolan Brewer. From Ms. Hall's class, Evelyn Alvarez. From Ms. Garrett's class, Emmeline Hall. For third grade, from Ms. Hester's class, Sam Barassa. From Ms. Lickey's class, Rhett Clanton. From Ms. Baker's class, Ollie Barfield. From Ms. Rozier's class, Adeline Reyes. From Ms. Wilkins' class, Caleb Tyson. From Ms. Loke's class, Mackenzie Martin. Fourth grade, from Ms. Knight's class, Landon Grave. From Ms. McCullough's class, Jackson Knight. From Ms. Rozier's class, Coy Battle. From Ms. Bell's class, Madison Newkirk. From Ms. Durden's class, Aria Cotiller Collins. From Ms. Thomas's class, Lucas Blankenship. From Ms. Brantley's class, Cohen Howard. For fifth grade, from Ms. Clay's class, Keegan Wentz. From Ms. Tanner's class, Ben Wood. From Ms. Davis's class, Tucker Malone. From Ms. Beal's class, Esmeralda Vasquez Navarro. From Ms. Hall's class, Landry Tyler. From Ms. Bryan's class, Gloria Eason. From Ms. Van Norman's class, Drayson Usry. Congratulations to these students of the month. We've got two more students of the month to recognize. Congratulations to Colin Hardy from Ms. Forney's class and Aiden Smith from Ms. Knight's class. Congratulations, Ms. Laura Thomas in fourth grade. She is our January Staff Member of the Month. Congratulations.
Light shine bright everywhere we go. Music for the people, making music for the people. Light shine bright.